Alright, just as a reminder, this page is out of this book. Black River Art presents Colorsome Cuteness, Christmas Edition, and the artist is Carlin Douglas. Copyright was in 2021 on this. And I love this little book. And I do have the other one. I don't believe I have it right here, though. Let me check. Nope, I don't have it right here. The other one I have that I mentioned, let me grab that real quick. And I did have it right here. So I'm looking. And that one is Holly Jolly Christmas, which was also copywritten in 2021. By the same artist, and these are just cute little drawings. So, very cute stuff. Alright, so what I'm doing at this stage is I'm working on the gifts. And you can see right here, Blender. What I have here, the Prismacolor, colorless blender, and I went over the scarf. A couple of little areas, you know, just to get rid of any of the little white specks by blending it out. And you can see right here is where I stopped. And I took a picture of it. In my last video, it was at the end of my last video, you could see this section very clearly that it was much lighter. So I'm just using the blender. So let me go ahead and do that. Let me get my and I'm just blending it, and I'm not pressing hard, and I'm doing it in the direction that the yarn threads actually travel. And the reason why I started doing this is because I thought, you know, there's an awful lot of light, you know, little specks. And I wanted to just blend them out without, you know, just over layering. So I thought, you know what, I'm going to just pull this out, this blender, and see what kind of results I can get. And again, like I said, I'm not pressing hard. I wonder what this is made out of. I mean, because I've heard that it's just the color pencil without any color. But it seems a little bit drier than that. So, makes me wonder. And anyways, so I went ahead and let me get this color off. Make sure that you do this between colors, or you'll drag in that color right into another piece that you work, another section that you're working on that maybe you didn't want that color. I think that looks really quite nice. So, and I have this whole section. But it just makes the colors pop. It just pops right out. So as I'm moving forward, I'll use this here and there just to get some intensity in that color. Try not to draw that, pull that dark color into that ribbon, or it's not going to be seen very well. Did a little gradient here, which I like. And to me, it looks like the edge of the box is right there, so it kind of left that little section there light. And I put some color up here, so it would highlight that. And then, over here, put a little highlight area on this. And so we're going to work on this one. My color. What color should I use? Like a red? Now that I'm far enough away from the hat, we can use the red. And so I can use permanent red and the crimson lake. I'm trying not to add too many colors. To this, just working on, you know, trying to use just a few colors, just introducing a few other colors like the purple and the green and the pink. But I'm going to try to keep that part simple here. So it do look quite lovely. amazing how much noise my dogs make. editing a video yesterday. Like, oh my goodness. Which, speaking of editing videos, I used to just do it with my phone. But I was having trouble getting, you know, being able to crop it and make it. I wanted to do some time lapse, and for some reason, I don't know what happened to the app, but that just disappeared. So, I have this. It's a video editor on my computer, so I'm taking lessons. So I'm doing a color video, and then, no lie, I spend probably 2 days, 2 full days, maybe even 3, depending on the length of the video, editing the video. So I'm sure it will be faster when I learn how to use the software. I mean, that's the real challenge. Figure out what I'm doing. You know, doing the voiceover, adding the little titles. All that stuff. Hopefully I'll get to the point where it'll look very decent. Right now I think it looks like a new person's doing it. Because I am. Alright, so that's the first layer. Well, maybe that's two layers. On that, so I'm sure I'm going to have that be red. I'm thinking the bow I'm going to make maybe I'll use goldenrod on there, or I'll use red. You see, I'm already changing my mind. good, that color. So let's get some dark in here, right? Although I don't know if this is going to be quite dark enough. Because, like on the ears, I really want those shadows. For me, whenever I'm laying down color, I always try to think about the shadows. If you can think about the shadows, it's going to help you get the depth that you want. I'm going to finish this up so I can get the some of the background done and, you know, get his fur all fluffed up. So I am going to, I've decided on these colors. I'm going to color this package here with the Copenhagen Blue, which is a PC906. And then I'm going to use probably, you know, a darker pencil for some shadowing, and I'll let you know when I do that. And then the shadow, that'll be probably this one, the dioxazine purple hue, which is PC132. And then the ribbon, I believe it's going to be these, at least these two colors, maybe three. The red, permanent red, which is PC122. And then for the shadows, I'm going to use Crimson Lake, which is the PC925. And this one right here, I decided I'm going to carry some of the color of the bear up a little bit more. So I'm going to use these colors. We'll see how it works out. But Spanish Orange, which is the PC1003, and the Sunburst Yellow, which is PC917. And then for some shadows, I'm going to use a dark purple, which is PC931 on that. Maybe I'll do the ribbon in, I don't know. Once I get the box package done, I'll decide what I'm going to do with the color of the ribbon. So let's get started, shall we? So I have been coloring, and I've been learning how to video edit, which is a challenge all by itself. It's taking me longer to get the editing done than this. Than the time I spend on the coloring. Isn't that crazy? I think it's crazy. So I'm probably going to go over this again, like I've been doing with some of these other packages, with the blender, colorless blender, and just blend them out. This one I've decided I'm going to just try to limit it to, you know, let's do one color and see how it looks. And everything is as we move forward. It's all, nothing is written in stone here. Now these are light layers, right? I'm not pressing hard at all. And I'm doing like little hatch and ovals. And you can get a lot of color down when you do that. Kind of funny, I like the cold way better than the heat. Look where I'm at. How many of you find yourself in the same situation where you like the heat and you're where it's really cold? But I've lived in both, so I know I'm not fooling myself. I would much rather be in a cooler environment. Life is fluid, so we'll see where things take us, right? So I think my next video, I'm going to color with the brute funners, I think, because I haven't used any of the brute funners in this book, Colors of Cuteness. I did use the Starjoy. What are they called? Starjoy Gold Premium Color Pencils. I used those on a couple of pages. So I'll do a brute runner page and see how those pencils like this paper. This paper doesn't have, it's not overly thick. It's like in between the cardstock and copy paper. And it does have smooth texture. And there's nothing on the back side, which I mentioned in one of my videos, just plain, so that you don't have to worry about bleed through if you're using markers or what have you. It seems to be a preference of mine nowadays, is nothing on the other side. But I'm not buying too many coloring books because I'm trying to color. I'm trying to color the coloring books and I'm not going to get them all colored, so I put them on my list. You know, we all have those lists, right? The coloring books I want, and I'll get them eventually. When you guys color, how do you color? You color, do you use the little circles? Do you lay the light color down first? Or do you lay the darker shade down first? Or do you do the middle shade? How is it that you color? And why do you do that? Do you have a reason for that? Do you just a personal preference? Just a preference, just something that you've always done and you never changed? Because, you know, I know we're all in those little habits of doing the same thing. Whether it's good or bad, it's, you know, neither. It's just the way it is. And you see, I'm putting down just a light layer. That's all I'm doing at this stage. We'll get some color and some depth in here. And when you do this, you make sure the light layers, as you're laying them down, try to go in different directions. Because if you're only going in one direction, you're not going to get as much color pencil down as if you were going in two directions. So if I go down here, I can get, because the pencil will get the ridges, the last layer. And when you're looking at something, just kind of don't really focus on it. And if you kind of let your eyes get blurry just a teeny bit, you can kind of see the shape. Kind of see the way that you've got the first two layers down. You can kind of tell, okay, well, this is how I want that. You have to start somewhere, right? You have to start with little tiny movements. I'm going to move to the darker one now. This one is the Crimson Lake. Of course, the object of this is not just to lay down the color, because if it was just to lay down the color, we could use anything. We could use markers to lay down the color. So I think I'm going to blend that blue and the red with the lighter colors. So let me see, do I want pink? That looks good for the shadow. So what if I take a canvas, the blush? Blush pink. Let me sharpen that real quick and see how that would look on the areas that I have that are lighter red. Well, that's a nice sharp pencil point. This is the one I had problems with earlier in the beginning of this coloring. Hopefully it doesn't break. This pencil, and this is Blue Violet Lake, and that is PC1079. And when you're using a blender, like we're going to be using, you have to make sure that you've got plenty of color on that paper. Because if you don't, you're going to just not get the effect that I believe that you're going to want. And you can see, if I was pressing hard, the point would be gone. Right? Would have broke. You can see the difference here. just by using a light color to blend it, it will fill in all of those little areas, just replacing all those little spots with this lighter blue without making it too much darker. You know, but you just pick a shade that's just, I don't know, two or three shades darker. I mean, I put it on the here, you see, this is this color right here. The, what is it? Blue Violet Lake. And then this is the, Copenhagen Blue. So it's a couple of shades. Tones, I guess is what it's called. Tones, lighter. Out of my way. Like that. I'm going to this with the even with the darker color so that can give it some shadow. Same with over here, I'm doing that with some of the darker color. Okay. Alright, that took a minute. I had to, you know, play ball with her for a little bit. But she's happy. She's a happy girl. Alright, so let's see. I'm working on this diagazine purple hue as the shadow color. Not sure what color I'm going to color the ribbon bow on this. Sure, it look like the brown paper ribbon. That's kind of what that was supposed to look like. But the shading is making it look kind of a grayish color. Greenish, almost. No. just work it like that. I think I'm going to put some maybe sand color on this. Let me check and see. What do I want? Sand? Is that what this one is? Yeah, this one's sand. This other one here is like a jasmine. Yeah. So let's see. Sand. It's a good color. No, it looks like dirt. Looks like sand. No, go with the, go with this. We'll go sand. Jasmine one just looks so... to muddy brown. I think this one I'm going to definitely go over with the gold glitter, because I think it would look really nice. So, maybe I'll go over that with the cream, just to lighten up some of that shading. There we go, and see, if this will be dark enough, let's check. Just to get a little bit of a shadow. Get the other color I'm gonna get out. That would do good is the, that was, yellow ochre, PC 942. But I think the one that's going to work really well, the goldenrod PC 1034. Okay, so let's get some brown in there for some, what, like my dark brown. There we go. Nice dark brown. And this is PC946. Look at that. In here for some nice shadows. Hey. Oh my goodness, girl. Oh my goodness. Just so you know, I'm multitasking here, and I am petting my little dog. Wants to be up on my lap right now. And coloring. Notice how when you are coloring and you're doing little intricate work, it really takes a lot of focus. And when you're doing that, you don't have a tendency to talk too much when you're doing that kind of thing. Alright, so hopefully that looks like I want it to look. So we'll see. something like that. Yeah. Alright, so that's in there, nice and dark. I do want to blend that a little bit, so I'm going to just use the sand and just blend the edges just a little bit. Not too much, just enough. See the shading, and then, like I said, I'll go over it with the gold glitter. I have my Posca pen, and this one is see if it says what size it is on here. 0.01 maybe. That's because it's fairly small. So this one works. This one actually is not as translucent as this gel pen, so I think I'm going to use the Lisa Posca for the fur. Get that all going. So let's just put it down. Now we have a lovely furry hat. So that was with the Posca pen. Very happy about that. And then with the ribbon here on this package, I have two really great colors. So let me show you, just do a little test strip here. So this is the gold. Let's see, glitter gold is this one that's got a little bit more of a orangey color. And then there's this one, which is a glitter yellow, golden yellow. And obviously it doesn't look anything like the pencil, the case. And these are the A&Art. I did a review on these. So you can go back and check that. These are lovely pencils. Very happy with them. For a beginner set, I never used color pencils, gel pens before. And I didn't want to spend the money on getting all of the refills that some of the other sets come with. And I really wanted this little rubber grip. So this is the set I picked, and I'm very happy about it. And if you are at all new to gel pens, or you want to know more about gel pens, then I do recommend Jennifer Stay, and her channel is Coloring Bliss. She has a fantastic video that I watched where she reviewed extensively, I really want to say like 15 or 20 sets of gel pens. So I recommend that video. If you're not sure what you're looking for, check it out. I think you'll be very happy. If you're looking to buy some, you'll be very happy with watching that video first. I think she's a great help for that. But so let me get into this. I am going to just color this in. I'm using this light one for the lights. Pardon. to touch up some areas. Got it. You're all covered. Looks good. There we go. So hopefully you can see that. I hope. Let me get up there and check. Kind of a bummer for the whole thing in the orange screen. There we go. So we can see that. Nice. Okay. So now I'm just going to do the stars. Do the stars up there. And like I said, those are going to be. Instead of getting silver, I got this glitter. Glitter white. Which looks excellent. I'll start with this one right here. So it goes in. I watch another colorist, and her name is Kay, Coloring with Kay, and she is all about the bling. She loves all the glitter. She uses glitter paints also, which I have not done. So for this one, I'm gonna call this finished because I don't know when I'm gonna choose to do the background. I might do several images and then do the backgrounds of all of them at the same time, because you know, if I'm going to be using stencils, I can just pull out all my stencils and do them all. And we'll see. There we go. So I forgot one thing here. I have to put the New York down at the bottom, which calling this finished. I can get the glitter up here. So you can see the glitter in the stars, and then the glitter in the moon, and then the New York. And there. Alright. Calling it finished. I'm going to sign it, and then it's done. Alright, and please don't forget to like and subscribe, and I'll see you on the next one. And have a great Thanksgiving and a great holiday, and we'll talk soon. Bye. Bye-bye.